Welcome back. Today we will going to discuss about the tentative topics, that is the antenna, tall types of the antenna, then antenna types, its coverage, then function of the different types of the antenna, its purpose, antenna principle and its application. Antenna is the device. Basically we will going to discuss about the unit number 6, which is called as the specific applications of an antenna. Antenna is a device for sending or receiving electromagnetic waves. Here the different features is able to show that the different rapid deployment stations for the landscope tower and the camouflage tower, the processor tower, steel tabular tower. Its picture is able to show that the single tube tower, the monopole type of the antenna. The antenna comes in the wide variety of the size and shapes. The antenna types, there are the different types of the antenna. Antenna will be categorized into the basically the 6 major types, which is called as the end fire antenna, loops antenna, then dipoles antenna, stubs antenna, slots antenna, and the aperture antenna. Then end fire antenna will be categorized into the polyrods antenna, helical antenna, Yagi-Uda antenna, log periodic antenna, and conical spiral type of the antenna. Here is the example of the helical type of the antenna. Then loops antenna, there are the different shapes and size of the loops. It may be the square, it may be the triangular, circular, elliptical, etc. Then dipole antenna is categorized into the 2 major classes, which is called as the folded dipole antenna and array. Then folded dipole antenna having twin line, which is the free biconical type of the antenna, and the long wire antenna, the beverage and the rhombic type of the antenna. That part we have seen in my previous video. Then array type of the antenna, that is the curtains type of the antenna, and W8 ZKS type of the antenna. Then stubs is the conical types of the antenna. Then slots antenna, patch antenna, array type of the antenna, and aperture antenna. Then aperture antenna is the major classified into the lenses, spirals, horns, and the reflectors. Then this horns and reflectors will be categorized into the flat horns, then the randoms, then corner, then FHS, and the reflector and parabolic. This is the example for the parabolic reflector type of the antenna. Then this is the different antenna types, that is the half wave dipole type of the antenna, its current distribution and its radiation pattern with respect to the electric field and magnetic field. Then quarter wave monopole type of the antenna, there is the single wire of the antenna and its another part is connected to the ground. It's the radiation pattern with respect to the electric field and magnetic field. Here is the helical antenna. The helical antenna, just like the spring structure and having the successive bend between the antenna, is lambda by 4 on vertically, and horizontally it is the lambda by 2, and its ground plane to do all the spring structure will be connected to the ground plane. Then this is the horn type of the antenna. And here this helical type of the antenna is generally used for in automobile industry. Then loop antenna, in the loop antenna it may be the square loop antenna, circular loop antenna, microstrip antenna. Nowadays also in a smartphone or cell phone, nowadays we use for communication purpose, that is the microstrip type of the antenna. Then flat antenna or cap antenna. Then this is the flat antenna or cap antenna, which is the sector antenna, sailing mount type of the antenna, polyrod type of the antenna, weep antenna. That weep antenna we have seen in detail afterwards my next video. Then omnidirectional and directional type of the antenna. In omnidirectional antenna, in the radio communication, the figure is able to show this is the omnidirectional type of the antenna. In radio communications, an omni antenna is radiates the radio wave power uniformly in the all directions in the one plane, with the radiated power decreasing with the elevation angle above or below the plane and dropping to the zero on the antenna axis. And the directional antenna or beam antenna is the antenna which radiates or receives the greater power in the specific directions, allowing for increased the performance and reduce the interference from the unwanted sources. The next Yagi-Uda type of the antenna. Yagi-Uda type of the antenna is driving element induces the current. Basically in Yagi-Uda antenna there are the three elements, and in that three element having the different function, but the signal is able to travel in the direction of the propagation in a one particular direction, that is the reflector, driving element and the director. The driving element induces the current in the parasitic element. When the parasitic element is slightly longer than the lambda by 2, then elements act as the inductively and thus act as the reflector. The current phase to the reinforced radiation in the maximum direction and the cancel in the opposite direction. The director element is slightly shorter than the lambda by 2, then the element act as the inductively and thus the director current phase to the reinforced direction radiation in the maximum direction and cancel the opposite direction. The elements are the separated by the 0.25 lambda. Then log periodic antenna. The log periodic antenna is the extension of the Yagi-Uda idea to the broadband. Perhaps the 4 times its wavelength is greater than the Yagi-Uda type of the antenna, with gain is approximately equal to 8 dB. And the log periodic are typically used in the high frequency or ultra high frequency bands. Then the parabolic reflector. In the parabolic reflector, in the schematic representation, to show that the parabolic reflector, once the signal is able to incident at the feed point, then it will be reflecting to the parabolic reflector and it come out from that reflector. The parabolic reflector operates much same way the reflecting the telescope dot does the reflection of the rays from the feed point in all contributes in the phase to the plane wave leaving the antenna along the antenna bore site, and typically it will be used for the ultra high frequency and higher frequency. Then next is the patch or panel type of the antenna. Patch or panel type of the antenna, as said earlier, this type of the antenna nowadays used for very high frequency due to that very small size, very thin size, and it is easily placed in cell phone or smartphone. So radiation is from the two slots on the left and right edges of the patch, when the slots are regioned between the patch and the ground plane. In this, the length lambda d, which is equal to lambda 0 epsilon r raised to 1/2, and its thickness is typically 0.01 lambda 0. The big advantages is the conformal, that is the flat shape and the low weight, and the disadvantages is the low gain, narrow bandwidth, and it overcome by the fancy shape and other heroic efforts, but it become hard to feed when complex, that is for the wide band applications. Then dipole antenna. In the dipole antenna is a straight element and a conductor measuring half wavelength from end to end, and it is connected at the center to the radio frequency feed line. Then monopole type of the antenna. The monopole antenna is the class of the radio antenna and consisting of the straight rod, just too simple, a straight rod, and this type of the antenna is used in the very smart cars, and often mounted perpendicularly over the some type of the conductive surface called the ground plane. Then isotropic antenna. The isotropic antenna is the ideal antenna that radiates its power uniformly in all directions. There is no actual physical isotropic antenna. However, isotropic antenna is often used in the reference antenna for the antenna gain, and the antenna gain is often specified in the decibel, dBi, decibel over the isotropic. But the isotropic radiation has the same intensity regardless of the direction of the measurement, and the isotropic field exerts the same action and regardless of how the test particles is oriented in the radiates uniformly in the all directions from a point source, sometimes called as the isotropic radiator. Then antenna coverage. In case of the antenna coverage, coverage provided from the villages, cities, forests, deserts, seas, air journey, buildings, hills, mountains, underground, college, schools and universities. Antenna functions. Basically the function is the transmission line. The power transport medium must avoid the power reflection, otherwise use the matching device. The radiator must radiate efficiently, must be a size compatible with the half wavelength, and it will be unavoidable for the broadband applications, and the resonance must be attenuated. Then antenna purpose, the transformation of the guided electromagnetic waves in a transmission line into freely propagated in a space with specified directional characteristics, and transformation from time function in one dimensional space into the time function in a three dimensional space. And the specific here is the wave will be radiated in all over directions, and the specific form of the radiated wave is defined by the antenna structure and the environment. This is the antenna principle. We have seen that there are the different parameters while design of an antenna, that is the radiation resistance, antenna pattern, directivity, gain, bandwidth, signal to noise ratio. Here is the US Navy, it will be operate for the 76 Hz and the millimeter of the wire penetrate to the underwater sub one way system. Here are the different applications. Here is the transmitting tower or ultra high frequency, very high frequency receiving antenna. Here is the wireless communication. Thanks for watching my video. If any queries, any doubts, you write my own comment page. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.